survivor, a young man who worked very hard to make this rally happen. The General Secretary of Four Culture Reviver of Maine, please welcome my friend Fadil Arbab.
Thank you so much for being here. I'm really so, I don't know how to tell you this, but I really feel so grateful that you guys are all here. That's really mean you guys care a lot about the issue. And you know, since the US Congress declared the Darfur genocide in 2004, in July 23rd, that President Bush, he declared that after Kofi Annan and General Colin Powell, they went to Darfur and they report and they announce it, this is as a genocide. But nobody take action. Nobody take action, and the genocide is still continuous, is going on, and now it's really expanding in rest of the Sudan. It's in Nuba Mountain now, and it's going to Blue Nile, and also in Abyei, and also in up north, in Nubian, and also in Eastern Sudan, later on will be in Bija, and also in Central Sudan, Khartoum, and all rest of the marginalized areas in Sudan. And just, I will just briefly share my story with you. I was 12 years old when government of Sudan and militia called Janjaweed, and they come and attack my village. And the way they come and attack, they come in very early morning, and they will just, the Janjaweed and the military forces, they will just come and surround the village. They do two circles. The first circle, they will take their guns and machetes, and the second circle, they will be riding their horses and camels. And they're saying for the kids and elders, we are not going to lose even one bullet on them. We have to burn them alive. We will save the bullets for those whom they strongly trying to escape the genocide. And they put their period time. They say by the end of 2011 or 2012, that we need to clean all the people from Darfur. We need the land to be clean, to be flat. They don't want to see anybody. For the girls and women, they systematically, they rape every single day. And also for the moms whom they have babies, they just take from their arms and they just kill them. For the girls, kill them and throw them in the wells. For the boys, they just, you know, mash their head, cut their head with the machete, and just put bunch of the kids together, put the, you know, the grass on top of them and just burn them. And also for the moms whom they have baby inside, they didn't born it yet, that they saying 100% that baby inside is gonna be baby boy. And if that baby boy born and raised, he will learn the history and in the future will against them. So they cut the mom's belly. And that, when they cut the belly, mom will die and the baby will die out at the same time. For the women whom they take the babies from them, they are not letting them to go alone. They're saying, if we let you go, you will find some kids that they've been hiding under their dead bodies, and you will take those kids and you will feed them from your breast, and they're cutting the mom's breast. And it's really very difficult. It's really breaking our heart. And now the same thing is happening to Nuba Mountain, and it's happening also to Abyei area, and also up north to the Nubian, and also is going to be going to Eastern Sudan, Bija, and also in Khartoum is really happening. And these kind of things is really, we struggle so much, 10 years for me to come to this country, and I was very lucky to survive the genocide. My face is get burned, my head is get burned, part of my body get burned, because when I was running in the street, they catch me and they throw me in the hut, and that's why I get burned. When I get to capital of Sudan, that was the hope to come and find my parents in capital of Sudan, but unfortunately, I end up in the street as a lost boy, and then I being captured by the government of Sudan, and I being a slave one of the government of Sudan's houses. And that, it was terrible. It was terrible, the experience I went through. I don't want any child around the world will go through, or any girls. And that, we really, we can't sleep at night. We've been thinking about those bad images, and all these things is coming every single second, every single minute, and just play in our mind, and I can't sleep at night, I have nightmare, I have bad dream. And that, we just say we have to do something locally, and we've been doing for 1 year and a half. We have to host a rally every 23rd of the month, because that is the declaration of Darfur genocide. And we say, why not? We're just doing locally here. We will expand it to all 50 states. And we just start reaching out. And we do that for all 50 states. And again, we expand it even to all around the world. And that's why today we have so many people from around the world and also around different states. They're doing the same things. Because it's really we the people, we the power. If we really come together and we really share our stories and we really move on, that we really will make a difference. And together, we will bring the peace to Sudan, and we will bring, you know, the freedom for all in Sudan, and also for all over the world and the other countries whom they are going through the genocide. And thank you so much for coming. Thank you. Bye.